Welcome to my channel. For those of you who do, I'm really sorry I've been a bit absent lately, but I've been super busy and now I decided I'm gonna get serious and I'm gonna post one video a week, hopefully. I'm not gonna promise anything. But yeah, last week was my birthday and I decided to throw a little party, of course. At first I thought it would be a normal party like every year, but then I got a bit inspired and I chose a theme, as you can probably guess, from my surroundings and my attire. I chose to throw a Hawaiian party. So today I'm gonna talk to you and talk you through how I organized my party. I just really hope I can help you organize an awesome party for you or for your friends, so we can all enjoy and have a great time together. So let's just get into the video, right? First thing you have to do when organizing a party is choose a theme. What I did, I was just walking around the shops, local shops, and I just checked what they had. I had a little idea in my mind what I wanted, but I didn't want to get my mind set on anything before I see what the shops have. So the next thing I did, I made a Pinterest board. I always do that. No matter what I'm organizing or what I'm searching through the internet, I always make myself a Pinterest board, because I think it's so much easier, so you can get your ideas really organized and you have them all there, and then you can pick and choose which one you like, which one you don't, which go together, which don't, and I think it's so much easier that way. On my Pinterest board I have many things. So the third thing I did, I took a piece of paper and wrote down what stuff I really want to have on my party. So getting all in that Hawaiian theme, I realized I really wanted a cocktail bar. The next thing I wanted is a photo booth, or at least some props so that you can take pictures with. And that's basically the most important things I wanted. And I wanted also some decorations in Hawaiian theme. When I wrote down everything on the list, I realized there was something missing, and that was music. And I realized that on the day of the party. So I just went on Spotify and found some Hawaiian party music, something like that. I just wanted something in the background when the guests arrived. Okay, so now I had in mind everything I wanted, and then I figured I should probably start thinking about the guests that I'm gonna invite. And of course I always invite family on my birthday parties, so I invited my aunts and cousins and family, friends and everyone, and I invited them at around 5 p.m. And then I decided I'm gonna do the party for my friends on the same day. I usually do it like that. Like my family comes at 5 p.m. and then I invite my friends over at around 8 p.m. and then we have the cake together at around 9 p.m. and then my family and my family friends, they usually leave. And then we have the party. So that's what I did this year. I didn't want to do any invites or big deal about that. I just called my family and my family friends and invited them over. And for my friends, I find it the easiest way is to make a Facebook event. About food, I realized that I don't really care what we're gonna eat. Except I really wanted a cake and some fruits, like fruit kebabs or something. I don't know how to say that, but you're gonna see it. So I just said to my dad, you can do whatever you want, I'm totally leaving up food to you, you can do whatever you want, and he took care of it. My mom did the cake, I helped her. It was like a double chocolate cake or something. So the cake was decorated with white and it had these little flowers on, which are fake, but I think they're still very cute. And they're pink, so I love them. I mean, not that I love pink that much, but it's nice, I guess. Okay, and the cake had these flowers on, and the bamboo leaves and sticks. And it was really simple to get it because we have bamboo everywhere around the house, and it wasn't hard to get that. And there comes the cocktail bar. I really wanted to do this for so long, and I finally did it. What I did, I googled recipes for some of my favorite cocktails, and I just made like a menu in Big Monkey. I don't know if you've heard of it, but it's really simple, and it's free, you can do it online, it's super easy and awesome. Out, and I wanted each to be on a separate paper so that they can be spread on the table and so that people can just see what we have and what they can do. So yeah, and then I took these maps that are really just a simple map. I cut this out. It was for the clip-clap folders, I guess. And I again cut some bamboo, and I stuck it around the folder, and I put each of the recipe inside the folder, and it, whoa. And at the end it looked like this. I think it looks super pretty and in the theme. I had many of these done, so I had Sex on the Beach, Strawberry Margarita, I couldn't go without Pina Colada because it's Hawaiian, then Cuba Libre, Mojito, and Tequila Sunrise, Screwdriver, I think that's all. So these were my cocktails, and I just spread this on the table, and anyone who came to my party could make himself a cocktail. And we had also those nice umbrellas that you can put on the fruit, and a nice fruit bowl, and all of the liquor, and everything you need to mix those cocktails. Spread it through, spread it on the table so that everyone could make their own cocktail. And I really love this. And I also had this, it's all falling apart, but it had bamboo all around, and it says "Zmieszaj si cocktail," which means mix yourself a cocktail, which was on this table with cocktail. That was all about food and drinks. Now let's go to decor. I always love doing decor for parties, so I had lots of DIYs. The only thing I actually bought was this, and I have a bunch of them here so that everyone who came to my party, every girl, could make one and put it on so that we can all be in a bit more party Hawaiian mood. The other things I did alone, actually with my friends, they helped me. Like this banner here, we used a bit thicker paper so that it was nicely standing up, it didn't fall down, and we just cut the letters out of it, and I wanted this aloha sign to be at the beginning, so when the people came to my party they saw this sign. And we decorated it the same way we decorated the flags. We also made these flags here. Okay, we have plenty of these flags with different kinds of decor on them. So yeah, we did the same thing for the flags and for the banner. We just cut some potatoes in the shapes we wanted, like stamps. potatoes and stamp it on the paper. The only thing that we draw was the watermelon, because it was easier to draw this little black dots than to stamp it on, I guess. So yeah, it was the same principle for everything. I hope you'll get it from the clips. But yeah. And we did the same thing for the flags, as I already said. We cut out from A4 paper these flags. They were like 10.5 centimeters here. Then here it was 1.5 centimeters. And here it was from here down. It was 16 centimeters, 16.1 to be exact. And from up to down was then altogether 17.6 centimeters. And my friend helped me cut them out. And then we stamped these things on. Flowers, pineapples, and, watermelons, all in theme of Hawaii. And then we made these holes and put the little flags on the cord, and that was it. It was quite simple to do, and I think it looked very lovely. So yeah, you can totally do it in any kind of party, and everything that I'm talking about, you can use the same principles in organizing other kinds of parties. So yeah, you can make this flags with whatever you want. I also wanted to do a photo booth, as I said, and so I made the same kind of banner or thingy as I did for the cocktail bar, and I wrote Uzemi pribomoci kinsenasme, see you, which means take a prop and smile, cheekies. And I had this on the table where I had all of my props. And the props were spread on the table in little mason jars filled with sand, so that they were like sticking out like this, that everyone could see them. So this was also kind of decor, but it was also useful. Guys enjoyed it, I hope I inspired you, and I hope you are gonna take the next party organization challenge, and I'm pretty sure that your friends and family will appreciate it. You can take my advice and use these tips in any kind of party, any kind of theme. You just need to think of the things that we talked about. And yeah, I hope you like it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you aren't already subscribed. And don't forget to leave in the comments down below who lives in a pineapple under the sea. I have to check the card. I'm such a loser. So, leave it in the comments below. That's pretty much it. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys very, very, very soon. Bye!